Hi everyone, this is Mary and Dave from PsychicSoulmateReading.com. Today we're going to give you a 3-card tarot reading for your week ahead or for whenever you're viewing this. It doesn't matter, even if you're viewing this after the date that I have uploaded, it doesn't matter. Spirit wants to give you a message, and even if the message doesn't resonate with you right now, visit later, because there's a message that is being told to you maybe in the future. So you got to be very alert and just go with the flow, and just whatever pops into your mind, that is what spirit wants to tell you. Okay. And so the cards that I'm working with are the Star Tarot. I have them here, but I don't have the box with me, but I love these cards. So before we begin, we're going to call on to a higher power, calling on to God, Jesus, the Ascended Masters. Please give us a message for our highest good, for what we all need to know right now, here and now. Okay. I brought Dave in the video with me.
She grabbed me. I was walking by.
For the divine masculine and feminine for your reading today.
I'm not very divine.
Okay, they're shuffled enough. Cutting them in 3 piles. Okay, so the first card is the 6 of Cups. Second, 9 of Wands. And 9 of Pentacles. Interesting, very interesting. Okay, so the 6 of Cups, they're very glossy cards, so you can't really see, but I'll try to make a blog post or post the cards on my website if I have the time to, I will. But the 6 of Cups, what this card is telling you is that you are holding on to something that doesn't really exist, holding on to the past. There's something that is, you are feeling that you love the moment of something that happened in the past, and you're not moving forward from that because you're holding on to that feeling that you once had, and that is not why that happened. You need to let that go and move forward. Now, it doesn't say to let go of someone. It doesn't mean that you have to find a new person or like let go of an old love or anything like that, or someone that's in your life. What it means is that you need to let go of trying to recreate that situation altogether, right? And so what do you see in the 6 of Cups?
Maybe is now a time to think of some nice memories that give you confidence and make you feel good about yourself, and realize that that same power is in you now, and just feel the good energy, sort of luxuriate or bask in the energy of those nice memories. Not to get lost in the past or anything like that, but just to use them now in the present moment as a way to remind yourself to spiral upwards.
Mm-hmm. Right. And the second card is the 9 of Wands. Now, the 9 of Wands represents that you are on guard, feeling like you're on guard, sort of like not allowing anybody, like if you're dating and you might be having issues of giving that person a second chance or another date, or even if it's even in love, it relates to if you're in a relationship, you might feel like there's a bit of a wall between the two of you because this person seems to be closed and you feel guarded. So when that person is guarded, you're guarded, and there's just that wall that's in between. So it's kind of like telling you that you need to put the guard down. Somebody has to initiate putting their pride down, because this is causing the guard and the walls. And the more you have pride, the more the other person will have pride, and it'll just go on and on and on. Now, it's also relating to just like just being free and just be carefree and just living, opening up your heart to somebody a little bit more. That's what it means. What does that mean to you, Dave?
I think you nailed it.
Oh. Dave sees it differently and I see it differently. So putting it together, you get the whole view of what you need to know. And whatever comes into your mind, that is the message. Okay, and so the third card is the 9 of Pentacles. And this is, I love this card. It relates to planting the seeds and allowing something to grow for yourself, but investing your time. And that is what you need to do. You need to invest time in yourself. when you love yourself, you can allow, attract other people to love you. The more you love you, the more other people will see that light. So be the light, invest, do whatever you need to do to invest into yourself. Now, when I say that, I'm not saying to go in debt of doing that, but it's about taking the time to actually nurture you. And this also relates to, it's a business card as well. Pentacles are business as well, material. So it relates to, don't be afraid to take that step forward in what you really want to do. Do what makes your heart sing. Do what makes your heart feel good. And you know, when you do that, you tell the universe, I want more. The universe will give you more. So it's about just stepping forward and not being afraid. What do you see in that?
Well, I'm just realizing there it's a nine, and the other one was a nine of wands before this, so I'm thinking maybe number nine has a significance, and that's usually a number of endings or completion, like a cycle has been completed. And in this case, nine of pentacles means to me that you are now in your own power, standing in your own power in a certain way, but connected to the earth and to enjoying. You've built up a certain amount of power where you can enjoy little luxuries of life, like whether that's a nice meal at a restaurant or, you know, whatever it is, going to the spa or whatever you do, those kinds of things. Like you actually can enjoy, you've worked hard and now you can enjoy life's little luxuries. And yeah, you're in a good place, that you're independent, kind of like more aligned with, you might get more accomplished on your own at this point than in a teamwork situation, if you're working on any projects or anything like that. Of course, we have to work with teamwork, but you just might feel a little bit more inner, kind of within yourself. Because to me, that card is, those cards are related to the Hermit card in the Major Arcana, which is a number nine, I think. Is that right?
I think it's a nine, yeah. That's
so
right.
It kind of relates to that whole thing of also being connected within, connected to the earth. And give yourself some nice little rewards, some nice little luxuries.
Yeah, exactly. Give yourself those rewards. You've done good. And it's about change, and change is good. Don't worry about what is going to happen. Don't worry about anything. Like, let go of the past and let go. That's what they're trying to tell you. How many times do I have to say, let go? Well, let go and surrender and just watch what happens. Watch the miracles unfold in your life. Okay, and so if you would like to learn more about getting a personalized reading, please visit my website, psychicsoulmatereading.com. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would really appreciate it. I thank you so much. My YouTube channel, my followers are growing, and it's because of you for watching me every week. And I appreciate your comments and your feedback. You don't know how much that makes me feel, because my message is to give you the message. We are just facilitators of divine light, and we all are here to teach and heal and help one another. Okay, so anyways, you have yourself a gorgeous day. Peace and blessings. Namaste.